market lost today 30 billion, 70 billion, 20 billion, like that. When the rate of interest goes up, it will create crisis. It happened. Everyone in the world now are looking to the Islamic financial system.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahi walhamdulillah. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillahi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wa ba'd. I welcome you back to the next session of the Dubai International Peace Convention. We will begin, insha'Allah, with a recitation from the glorious Quran. So I invite to give a reading Sheikh Adil Hamid Sharaf from Yemen, who is the Imam of Masjid Sayyida Khadija in Qusais. So please take to the stage, dear Sheikh Adil Hamid Sharaf.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الذين ينفقون أموالهم بالليل والنهار بالليل والنهار سرا وعلانية فلهم أجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون الذين يأكلون الربا لا يقومون إلا كما يقوم لا يقومون إلا كما يقوم الذي يتخبطه الشيطان من المس ذلك بأنهم قالوا إنما البيع مثل الربا وأحل الله البيع وحرم الربا فمن جاءه موعظة من ربه فانتهى فله ما سلف وأمره إلى الله ومن عاد فأولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون يمحق الله الربا ويربي الصدقات والله لا يحب كل كفار أثيم إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وأقاموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة لهم أجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وذروا ما بقي من الربا إن كنتم مؤمنين فإن لم تفعلوا فأذنوا بحرب من الله ورسوله وَإِن تُبْتُمْ فَلَكُمْ رُؤُوسُ أَمْوَالِكُمْ لَا تَظْلِمُونَ وَلَا تُظْلَمُونَ
جزاك الله خيرا, dear Sheikh Adil Hamid Sharaf. The next of today's speakers will be Dr. Hussein Hamid Hassan from Egypt. He will be addressing us, insha'Allah, on the topic of Islamic economics, the solution for the global financial crisis. A brief background about the Sheikh before we invite him to take to the stage. Dr. Hussein Hamid Hassan is considered as the father of Islamic finance. He received his PhD from the Faculty of Sharia at Al-Azhar University in Cairo in 1965 and holds 2 degrees in law from the International Institute of Comparative Law at the University of New York. He chairs the Sharia Supervisory Committee of many Islamic banks in the Middle East and has advised several governments. An expert in the field of law, he had been the Attorney General for the Government of Egypt between 1969 and 1970. He has advised several governments in the Middle East and former CIS countries on the establishment of Islamic financial institutions. So I would like to invite to the stage, first of all, before we do invite him to give his talk, Dr. Hamid Hassan, who will be, insha'Allah, receiving a memento, Mr. Ahmed Zahid, the Director of Public Relations and Media of the Islamic Affairs and Charitable Activities. So I invite the two of our guests to the stage.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
So if I could invite to the stage Mr. Ahmed Zahid, the Director of Public Relations and Media for the Islamic Affairs and Charitable Activities. And in return, our dear Sheikh will be presenting to Mr. Ahmed Zahid a book which is titled The Financial Crisis, Roots and Remedies, which was written by one of our fellow speakers, Mr. M.M. Akbar, which was released by Dr. Hamid Hussein, which will be received on behalf of Mr. Ahmed Zahid. Jazakumullahu khairan. So we will now be addressed, insha'Allah, on the topic of Islamic economics, the solution for the global financial crisis.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala Sayyidina Rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa ba'd. Brothers and sisters, our topic today is one of the miracles of Islam. Islam has its own economical and financial system which was not only revealed but practiced for 14 centuries all over the world. And now, when Muslims followed sincerely their Sharia in general and their financial system in particular, they have some kind of economy which we have never seen in any economy. Let me give you examples, because it is not only to say that the Islamic financial system is a miracle, real miracle. Mu'adh ibn Jabal, companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was sent in the days of Abu Bakr to Yemen after Umar was the caliph. He kept him in Yemen. And listen to me, what Abu Ubaid in his famous book Al-Amwal, what he said: I collected zakah from Yemen and distributed what I could distribute for mustahiqeen, those who are entitled to zakah, fuqara and masakeen. Then one third of the zakat collection, the proceeds, were kept. What to do with it? I sent to Umar in the center, in the capital, to Medina, to find ways and means to spend the zakat to mustahiqeen. He said, Umar wrote to me, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أما بعد فإني لم أبعثك جابيا ولا آخذ جزية إنما بعثتك لتأخذ الزكاة من أغنيائهم فتردها على فقرائهم. Mu'adh was frightened, was very sad. Umar told him, why you sent to me? It is not our Islamic principle to collect from the parts of the Muslim country and to bring it to the center. I have sent you to take zakat, collect the zakat from the rich and give it to the needy in the same province. He wrote to him, Wallahi, Wallahi, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ma ba'athtu ilayka bi shay' وَأَنَا أَجِدُ أَحَدًا يَأْخُذُهُ مِنِّي. I have never sent, I haven't sent to you anything and I find someone to take it from me. No one. I go here and there. This what I could distribute. The rest I could not. What to do? Mu'adh said, second year, he distributed zakat. Collected and distributed zakat. He could distribute one third and send it to Umar two thirds of zakat. Umar sent to him the same very strong message and he told him the same answer. And in the third year, as Abu Ubaid says, Muaz collected zakah and could not distribute, and he sent the proceeds to Umar and told him, this is the case, what to do? I could not find anyone in Yemen to take from me zakat. This is the economy based on iman, believe in Allah, committed to His revelation, applying His principles, His guidance. Have you seen or heard in any book, in any economy, in the history, that a development plan in 3 years in a province like Yemen, that the whole citizens are zakat, let us say, in the other system, as tax zakat payer, and no one is in need to accept the zakat. This is happening when Muslims applied, implemented, followed their Islam and their financial system. In the days of Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz, he appointed a governor for Iraq, Abd al-Hamid ibn Abd al-Rahman, as narrated by Abu Ubaid also, بسند صحيح. Abd al-Hamid ibn Abd al-Rahman send a message to the caliph, to the head of the state, telling him, I have a problem. This is the kind of problem under the umbrella of Islam, real belief and commitment and devotion to Allah. This is the kind of problem. Listen to me. I have a problem, ya Amir al-Mu'mineen. Help me to solve it. What is that? He said, أَعْطَيْتُ النَّاسَ أُعْطِيَاتِهِمْ وَبَقِيَ فِي بَيْتِ مَالِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ مَالِ فَمَاذَا أَصْنَعُ بِهِ. He said, I gave everyone, all مستحقين, all needy, everyone, but I have still I have in the treasury from zakat and the other resources, I have mal. What to do with it? Tell me, this is the problem. When we applied for the Islam, this is اقتصاد الرفاه, اقتصاد الوفرة, this is غنى, this is kind of economy, what Muslim used to live. These are examples. When they followed Islam, no crisis, of course, this kind of problems. And what Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz told him, انظر كل من استدان في غير صرف ولا بزخ فأد عنه دينه فإن الدين هم بالليل وغم بالنهار. He told him, see, look, find out of anyone of the citizens of Iraq who's under debt, give him to pay out his debt. We don't want a citizen who lives in the Islamic State under the Islamic Quran and the Sunnah. We don't want to see someone to sleep one night under debt. Good debt is a kind of slavery. Abdul Hamid wrote to him, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ana qad fa'alt. Do you think that I missed this? No, I have done it also. Al-Gharimeen, I gave this share for those who are under debt, suffering from their debt. But I still have funds, I still have mal. He said, this is the history of Islam. This is the economy and financial system under Islam. He said, انظر كل بكر لم يتزوج فشاء أن تزوجه فزوجه وأصدق عنه. Look to anyone, young boy or young lady, who's willing to get married, to establish a family, new family, and pay him the cost. Have you seen in any economy there is the chapter 4 al-i'faf or tazweej al-abkar? Never in humanity. This is only under Islam. And anyhow, he told him, I have done it. I have done it. Then he told him, انظر من قبلك من أهل الذمة قد ضعف عن زراعة أرضه فأعطه ما يقوى به على زراعة أرضه فإننا لا نريدهم لعام ولا عامين. انظر the non-Muslims. Non-Muslims, أهل الذمة, the citizens of the Islamic State who are not Muslims. Give them if they need. They used to cultivate their land. If they need, give them. فإننا لا نريدهم لعام ولا عامين. They are our citizens. We are not just to need them for 1 year, 2 years. No, they can live with us. Be our citizens. And if I go to tell you what was the picture of the Islamic, of the economy of Islam, of the financial system of Islam, but let me tell you what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا لَفَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتٍ مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And a crisis in the days of Nuh, financial crisis. What was the solution? فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِذْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا مَا لَكُمْ لَا تَرْجُونَ لِلَّهِ وَقَارًا. This was the prescription for this crisis. Go back to Allah. Repent to Allah. Rely to Allah. Leave injustice. And Allah will give you, because He is the Razzaq. He is the giver. No one can do this. Means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he wanted to tell Quraysh that this is what they have, peace and wealth, He said, فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف. This is the case. Allah is the one, if you follow His path, His way, implement His principles. Let us come what humanity has done. You have seen two systems, two superpowers in the world, supreme power. This is the socialist or say communism and the capitalism. I think no need to talk about socialism because it passed away and buried, and I was one of those who witnessed the funeral of the social system, former Soviet Union, in the days of Gorbachev. Whole humanity, Gorbachev invited hundreds of experts from all over the world to help to keep the collapse of the social system. It was like a tower falling down and you're asking someone to keep it with his hand. It was impossible. Anything which was not taken from, based on Islam in Allah's revelation, will go. Will go. قُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقِّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلِ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ زَهُوقًا. Fall down. Finished. And now the capital system. What happened to the capital system? Capital system, they used to say, this system is a free economy. Free economical system. But it fall down. Not only this time. From 1929, 80, 70, this system, capital system, is riba-based, riba. And the brother who recited the Quran before I came to the stage, he said, الذين يأكلون الربا, those who eat riba, interest-based financing, لا يقومون إلا كما يقوم الذي يتخبطه الشيطان من الماس. This is one miracle. Look to the stock markets. Go and see your eyes. How the investors in shares, they said the market lost today 30 billion, 70 billion, 20 billion, like that. Some of them fall down. Fall down. Died in the hole. In the hole of the market. Because it Allah said, and they are like that. Like mad people. لا يقومون إلا كما يقوم الذي يتخبطه الشيطان من الماس. Yes, mass. ذلك بأنهم قالوا إنما البيع مثل الربا. They said, okay, it is the based riba, interest based economy like this. Now, I want to tell you, the whole world, United States, Europe, and also in Asia, Japan, the whole world now came to know the truth that after the collapse of the social system in 1990, and now after the collapse of this capital system, there is no system, no available financial system to protect humanity and to solve their problems except the Islamic financial system. Allah, صدق الله إذ يقول سنريهم آياتنا في الآفاق وفي أنفسهم حتى يتبين لهم أنه الحق. When we sit with the Europeans and the others, this expert of and economists and the bankers and all these people, what they say that the capital system, this crisis we are living in, this crisis because of the rate of interest. Even I had heard myself, some leaders, to say, yeah, this is because of the rate of interest. It is shaitan. If the rate of interest goes up, it will create musibah. It will create financial crisis. And if it goes down, it will create musibah, fasad. Another crisis that's happened in this mortgage in the United States. And no one is allowed to interfere. Otherwise, he will be accused to be a socialist in a free economy. When the rate of interest goes up, it will create crisis. It happened many times because the cost of financing, if the people put their money in the bank, the cost of financing will be high. And then no development, no production. There is recession of the economy, the mood. And what happened in the United States? In short, because we have only 40 minutes to say, what happened exactly? That rate of interest reduced, came down very, very low. Banks, to get profit, they gave loans to those who are able to pay back or those who are not able to pay back. Mean they haven't done this due diligence to know credibility, who will be able, not be able, just to give. And after that, the borrowers who got loan for houses, they couldn't pay. They couldn't pay. Then interest accumulated. And they were kicked out of their homes because the banks want to get their debt. They kicked out of houses to sell it. But the banks could not sell it. Why? Because the offer, the demand is, who will buy? And many the supplies too much, then houses, means real estate, came down 50%, sometimes 60%, because there are many houses. Banks want to sell it. And we have seen for the first time some American families who kicked from their homes. They live in a tent in any park in the street because they could not pay their debt. They were kicked. Banks wants to sell the houses, but even banks could not sell it because no buyers. No buyers. Many, the supply is too much. And even if someone wants to buy, he needs to go to have loan again from bank. Banks are not ready to do it. Then the crisis started from there. And the banks, what did? They take some interest. If they gave the loan with, say, 6, they kept 2 for themselves. And then they make it bonds, securitize it, make it certificate to sell it again. Trade of debt, sale of debt. We will know that all this is rejected by Islam, by Sharia. And then make it security. And they went to insurance companies, they insure it. And they went to rating agencies to evaluate. They gave it AAA as very good debt, and debtors are in the streets. What happened that when, and then they sold it to some pension funds, to some sovereign funds, to the others. These bonds with interest, with riba. and everyone collapsed. 168 banks last year until yesterday. In this new year, 2010, 20 more banks in the United States alone became bankrupt. And the insurance company, of course, could not pay. And then the company was bankrupt, the biggest insurance companies. It is something, a crime against humanity. And the whole world is suffering. And four Islamic financial system and Islamic banks, we came to know by their own confession that the only system which has no cause of this crisis is the Islamic financial system. Why? Number one, I mean, even if you want to solve this crisis, they were not guided how to solve it. We know that United States Bush gave $70 billion, not to the poor people who were kicked out of their houses, and they were staying in the streets. He could give them this $70 billion. Or Obama after that, $80 billion to pay their debts to the banks and to go back to their homes. And the problem of the banks and the whole crisis would have been solved. Of course, if you pay this money to these people, they will pay their debt to the banks and they will go to their homes and no problems. And the whole world is all suffering. But those who created, who are reason for this crisis, they are not suffering. Why? Because the investors went to them and invested their money in factories, in infrastructure, in houses, and they still have their houses. Everything, assets are there. But the investor came back without anything. No one is carrying any building or any factory. Factories are there. The whole economy is working. Anyhow, let us go step that why Islamic financial system is the only solution, the only salvation, the only protection. Everyone in the world now are looking to the Islamic financial system. European countries amended their legal systems to allow Islamic financial system and Islamic banks to operate in Europe. You find Islamic banks in London, in Moscow, you have Sukuk in Germany, Sukuk in China. The whole world is looking, because no other way. Social system has gone, has passed away. And this capital system has fallen down. They used to tell people that this system, this capital system has its own force. They used to tell us when we were studying, if the system, if the economy falls down, don't worry. Don't move a finger. It will come up by itself. But now it falls down. The whole humanity, with all efforts, all funds and monies, everywhere the government is paying billions, no one could bring it up unless Allah wants to be merciful for His creature, to save humanity. Because Allah says, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فإن له معيشة ضنكا ضنكا. This humanity is living in dank because they deviated from Islam, from the way of what Allah has advised them. Allah said, فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. This is the economy of dank. Not only crisis. No, it is more than crisis. It is dank. They are telling us there is a scarcity of food. There is a problem coming to humanity because of food will not be sufficient. What kind of economical system in which we, even humanity has not, is afraid not to get to eat even food. Allah خلق الأرض وقدر فيها أقواتها. Allah has given his creation more than sufficient. Islamic financial system is not interest-based system. No interest at all. From the beginning, no riba. يمحق الله الربا. Have you seen محق better than this? محق, this example. محق means to clean it, nothing. The whole world will be poor. You may agree with me that we used to hear that a company has become bankrupt, okay? But have you heard that governments, countries are bankrupt? Yes, under this system, violation of Allah's laws and the principles. This bank, even Greece, Al-Yunan, Greece, is bankrupt. Some others before, last year, when another government was bankrupt, and we don't know who's number two or number three, because Allah said, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنكًا. We don't have riba, we don't have interest, and this is reason for the crisis. We don't trade debts to sell and buy debt. Sharia said no. نهى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن بيع الدين بالدين. الكالئ بالكالئ. Prophet said 14 centuries back, don't trade debts. No. Don't trade debts. We don't securitize debts and sell it in bonds. We don't have. A Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, 14 centuries back, he said, لا تبع ما ليس عندك. Don't sell what you don't own. You don't have title. Now short sale. They have something in the market, stock market, called short sale. Short sale to borrow shares at a time when the market is high to sell it, and then you return it at a time you think that shares will be cheaper, and then you return it back. The brokers, they spoil the market. If they borrow some shares from one company, before they want to return the shares back, they can do some kind of illegal actions to make it less. But let me tell you at the end, under this capital system, the system which deviates from all Allah's rules and principles, you know how much was spent notional money and the nashat activities in qimar, in gambling, in maisir? 600 trillion dollar. These are transactions, no investment, no production of goods or services, no development, nothing, only gambling. They call it derivatives, mushtaqat. Derivatives, options, futures, all gambling in the market. You know how much the whole world How much? The whole wealth, wealth, ثروة, the real economy, the wealth of humanity now, all who what the world own, $60 trillion, 60, and 600 trillion were gambling in what we call it stock markets. Stock markets for shares, for currencies, for commodities, 600 trillion in gambling, in qimar. This is a crime against humanity. Imagine that the whole world lives with $60 trillion. Imagine if 600 trillion were real economy in development, in production. Imagine what humanity should have been now. Wallahi, even those who are, we saw them even half dying of hunger and illness will be millionaire. But this is a crime. That is why Allah again said, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا. Donkey means it's not a problem, it's not crisis, nothing. It's more than this. Donkey, the life itself will be hardship. Not that their life will have hardships. No. Their life will be, they will have problems. No. معيشةً ضنك. Life itself is a ضنك. Life itself is a ضنك. Economically, socially, politically, I mean psychologically, everything. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى remind us, we may think to say, okay, this is a punishment for them. Means it is good. They are punished in this life. It's punishment to clean them, to forgive their sins. Allah said, no. Those who don't follow Islam and the Islamic financial system, قال ونحشره يوم القيامة أعمى. We will bring him in the hereafter blind. That dunk in the life and the hereafter in hell. In hell. Alhamdulillah that now when we attend the conferences anywhere, they are saying, not us, those non-Muslims, they are saying this interest riba is the reason, these are the causes of this crisis. And no way out unless we adopt Islamic financial system. You know that the Bob of Rome, he addressed the whole world last year, said to them to get out of this crisis, go to Quran, go to Islam, you are allowed, you are Christian, but look to your life. Go to Quran, and everywhere, you know, in France, Congress of France, Constituent Committee, agreed that Islamic finance is not against secularism, secular constitution, and in Paris, the first education institution, academy for Islamic finance and Islamic banks, established in Paris. They expected the whole of Europe will adopt Islamic financial system. No, if not under the name Islam, but they will take it because no other way, no available system. And they want to reduce manpower in France in this academy of Islamic banks for those who want to adopt Islamic banks. Everywhere, many banks, conventional banks, are converted into Islamic banks every day, everywhere. And new Islamic banks, new laws. I tell you something. The Nur Sultan Nazarbayev of Kazakhstan, president of Kazakhstan, he asked to prepare a law for Islamic banking law for Kazakhstan after the crisis. We contributed to the preparation of this law, submitted to the parliament. You know what is the news? That this law passed by 88 out of 88. 100% how Muslims are waiting for their Islam. Anyone to give them a chance to be in peace with Allah. Riba is war with Allah. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَفَعَلُوا فَأَذَنُوا بِحَرْبًا مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. Are we able to accept this challenge? War from Allah and His Prophet? And do we need مَحْقَ يَمْحَقُ اللَّهُ الرِّبَى? That's why in Turkey they are preparing also. They have Islamic banks in Turkey, in London, in Moscow, anywhere. The whole world is coming back. This is haq. This is haq. سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا. Allah says so. We will show them our science, our miracles. فِي الْآفَاقِ. Everywhere. وَفِي أَنفُسِهِمْ. لِحَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَهُمْ أَنَّهُ الْحَقِّ. Now it is clear that this haq. My brothers, sisters, I would like to say that Muslims, when they believed and committed to Islam, they were rahma lil alameen, mercy for humanity, not only for themselves. Now the time came to carry this message, to carry it to humanity. We were talking about peace yesterday, and there is no peace without justice. Allah said in the Quran, الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ آمِنَةً مُطْمَئِنَّةً يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ. I mean peace and food goes together. Means if we want to have a very, to be as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us to be, خير أمة أخرجت للناس, for Muslim only, completely, not partially, completely to go to their religion, again to go to these days where they were rahmah lil alameen. And the muazzin used to say Allahu Akbar, no one else to say against this, because Islam controlled in 23 years the Persian Empire, Roman Empire, and the whole world were like that at the time. Means Islam control. For mercy, for what? Mu'assid, for care and barakah for humanity. I would like to stop here. Just I gave you the message. Just to receive any queries or questions, if you want to ask in what I have just presented to you. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakum Allahu khaira. That is all the time that we do have for the question and answer session. So a big thank you, may Allah reward Dr. Hussein Hamid Hassan. Jazakallahu khaira.
شكرا.
Islamic financial system is not interest-based system. They said the market lost today 30 billion, 70 billion, 20 billion, like that. When the rate of interest goes up, it will create crisis. It happened. Everyone in the world now are looking to the Islamic financial system.